All the world's a stage. This phrase is coined by William Shakespeare first time in his play, As You Like It. Indeed, this is a monologue. Monologue means a long narrative in form of a poem. Today, we will see and learn the difficult words and meaning. Before it, we start working on exercises of this long monologue. Let us start. Words and meaning. First one word, in very first line, indeed in second line you will find merrily. And all the men and women merrily players. Meaning, only or simply. And all the men and women only players, simply player. Second word is infant. I think in fifth one line you will find the word. At first, the infant mewling and puking in the nurse's arm. Infant, we all know, very young child or toddler. Third one word is mewling. Mewling. In next line, you will find at first the infant mewling and puking in the nurse's arm. Mewling mean crying weakly. Usually small children cry weakly. Right? So mewling mean crying weakly. Next is puking. One more thing that very young children or infant do is puking, mean vomit or cough up. They cough and give out whatever they have eaten or drunken. Next is whining. In next line, you will find and then the whining schoolboy with his satchel. Whining mean a child that cry unpleasantly, a long high-pitched noise. Right? Sometime we have seen that children cry unpleasantly. Usually when they are going to school, then so whining mean cry unpleasantly. Now we will move further. Next word is satchel in the same line, and then the whining schoolboy with his satchel. Satchel mean a small bag, your school bag. Usually school going children don't go to school happily. First they cry, they do something that shows that they are not they don't want to go to school. Then with their satchel, their small bag, they move forward. After it, woeful. Woeful. Woeful mean very sad. In next lines, I think this is in the middle third one line, and meaning of woeful is very sad. And then the lover sighing like furnace with a woeful ballad. Woeful mean very sad. When that person acts as a lover, what does he do? He sighs like a furnace. And these sighings are very woeful, very sad. Next is ballad. Ballad is a long song or a narrative song, you can say. Carol we also call that. And what happens with that young man when he acts as a lover? He sings song, woeful songs in the memory of his beloved one or mistress, you can say. Next is part. This is after that, maybe fifth or sixth line. jealous and sorry, full of strange oath and bearded like the pard. Pard mean fellow or friend or partner. You have seen in army that all the soldiers you always wear same uniform and their haircut is also same. So pard mean fellow or friend, and according to the line, full of strange oath and bearded like the pard mean they have same beard. Next, bubble reputation. As we all know that bubble is empty. So by seeking the bubble reputation, Shakespeare means that the man does things that make him look good, even they are pointless. Sometime for getting reputation, whatever we do, sometime that is pointless or has no importance. But man tries to get that reputation just for keeping himself in the competition, and they do these type of people do that just for raise their name. Sometimes we find that all the efforts are useless, all the things, all the matters are useless, but they involve themselves in them just for getting bubble reputation. Next word is capon. Capon is a male chicken. This is on the other side of the page. Not on the other side of the page, but this is second last line. In fair round belly with good capon length. A male chicken. Meaning of capon is male chicken. And now when the man is aged one, he has got a big belly, and it seems that this big belly is due to eating lots of meat. So capon mean a male chicken. Next, hose. Hosiery word you have heard. Hose mean stocking or socks, you can say, right? In this word is in the on the other side, and this is fifth one line. His youthful hose will save a world too wide. Sometime we save something for our future. So in the period of youth, people usually save something for their old age. So these are those stocking. When we will do paraphrasing, then we will explain that we will learn the explanation about that. Next is shank. Shank mean meat, right? This is in very next line. For his shrunk shank and his big manly voice. Shrunk shank mean when the man is aged one, what we can say that his legs are very thin, and we find less meat on the body, on the bones, right? So shrunk shank mean with very less meat on the body, you can say. Next, oblivion. Oblivion mean this is mental blankness or unconsciousness. As we are grown up, what happened to us, we lose our consciousness. Some of the memories or some of the events of the life are removed from our memory. So we call that mental blankness. We don't remember the things or event of our life too. Then sans. In last line you will see the repetition of that word sans. Sans eyes, sans teeth, and sans taste, sans everything. So meaning of sans is without. As the time passes, first in one's old age, that person loses teeth, then eyes. We have weak eyesight, we have fallen teeth, Then taste. There is no taste in food, and we find all the food same, and then sans everything. And after the word meaning, I'm giving you idea of exercise B. These are question answer. If you are able to write answer of the question, you must write answer. But if you feel difficulty, then wait for the paraphrasing. Inshallah ta'ala, in next sitting, I will upload here paraphrasing of the poem, line by line explanation of the poem. Then I think you must be able to write answer of the questions in your own word. Till that, just see the question, and if you find them easy, then you can write answer. Question number one is, why does Shakespeare call the world a stage? Second question, what impression is created of a judge? Third one, what happens in the last scene? Fourth one, what is meant by bubble reputation? And inshallah ta'ala, in next sitting, I will explain you the whole poem line by line. And till that, thank you, and Allah Hafiz.